They'll just say, get out of here. Get out of here. I forget which flight it was one time. They're like, what is this? They always do that with a 35-millimeter camera, you know, video camera. And I go, you know what it is. You're just trying to act like I'm guilty for some power trip because you've been told to train us to be prisoners. But you're too stupid to understand all of what's happening. You enjoying the cancer? You're going to get cancer from these x-ray machines and these scanners. Just get out of here. Yeah, I'm not scared of you. Oh, you're going to have fun when the next little kid comes through? Huh? See, I'm done. I'm done. I see you. I know you. I study this 24/7. I'm right. You're wrong. Period. And I'm not afraid anymore. And again, 15% of people are not re-enrolling previous the other number. They project they're going to cancel 500 classes in the summer. It could be 1,000. And one of the biggest community college systems in the world, Austin Community College. And look what's on their front page. Bacterial meningitis is requirement. Guess whoever took that shot, so brain damage, it's not even separated. I guess that's how you spell meningitis. The point is, let's put it back up on screen there. It's a requirement, not a law. They're supposed to give you the waiver for the policy, but the battle with the administrators is they go, look, we're totally imploding here. Doesn't matter. The brain damaging, the soft killing of people is more important that they be implanted with those viruses and heavy metals than that they... That is, so what? Some escape, they'll get them later. To have a job, to live, they're going to try to make you take shots. They're now giving kids shots in California without parental consent. So there you go. You can't go to college unless you get the deadly bioweapon. I'd seen the longevity products work. The globalists have taken over countless countries and committed genocide. Why not do it to the biggest plum of all, the United States? All over the country, they're having giant urban warfare drills with parachuting troops, helicopters, gunboats landing in Tampa. If you're watching on prisonplanet.tv, we'll show you the Daily Mail has an article and photos and videos of it. There's also an article at infowars.com linked to it all by Kurt Nemo, Black Helicopter Special Forces, trained for RNC police state. And the citizens are all, yay, America. That's not America anymore. It's like everybody, yay, Blackwater that is based in Dubai. They work for the New World Order. And it's all like, oh, it's so manly that they've got... You know, the troops jumping out of helicopters and riding in on their gunboats to keep us safe from the people. And all the good old boys get out there and, yay, America! Yay, America! America's gone, pal. Oh, look, they're riding in with their Gatling gun. They got a little Chinese-made American flag hanging there. This is what we become. And the local police are involved in it, so they're all with the military. They're openly getting you ready for military occupation. Everybody's clapping, yay, 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 take my guns, yay, 30,000 drones. I'm so glad we've been captured by foreign banks. Oh, hey, Facebook comes out and puts out a stock release publicly to rip everybody off. Oh, it's okay. It's fun to be ripped off. It's cool. American Idol's on, Dancing with the Stars. Jack in New York, you're on the air. Welcome.
Hey, Alex.
Hey.
I enjoyed Lord Monckton yesterday. It was fantastic. And I just wanted to ask you a question. You got the new social network up and running. I've joined. But I was wondering, is it possible for you to put up a video on there where... somebody with that's very good at research could help people to learn how to research, because a lot of the people that I reach, a lot of people I speak to, and you know, as I post articles on Facebook and so on,
yeah,
that these people they really don't know how to research. They have no idea how they could look up this thing, you know, these things to verify them.
Oh, my gosh. I mean, there's like probably over 100 articles a day and government documents at Infowars.com alone. All they got to do is go to Infowars.com. All of my films are free online. They have the articles, as I say it, or the clips from Congress. I mean, if people don't know we're in trouble, they're not paying attention, as the bumper sticker says. I mean, I don't know what else I can say The system admits they're overthrowing the Bill of Rights and Constitution. I can't do everything. I mean, I was up here till 10 o'clock last night, again yesterday. I'm not even doing the nightly news right now. The crew is. I'm getting ready for Bilderberg. I'll be doing it, some of it from there. I'm doing the radio show, everything. And people are always like, well, where's your proof? The Rockefeller Foundation had plans to put sterilants in vaccines. Just type in Rockefeller Foundation documents, sterilants and vaccines, and it will put it in the search engine. Just put in the search engine what I say, and that will come up with links to them. They don't hide this. The White House science czar says sterilize people. He doesn't hide it. The big journal of bioethics says kill children up to age 3, including healthy ones. Sounds insane. It is insane. That's what Hitler was insane, and that really happened too. People are like, you know, I say Hitler killed millions of people. Well, where's the proof of that? Well, here it is. People who always say Hitler didn't kill anybody and was a nice guy, they're like, but we do need to kill all the Jews, though. You know, Hitler didn't kill any Jews, but we need to kill him. He didn't kill enough of them. I'm like, oh, there it is. Now, there's a president's five-year review, an annual report, 1968. The Rockefeller Foundation, and that got declassified in 2001. And that's the sterilants in your shots. A little double cancer in there, too. It implants itself in your cell walls. It's designed on average when you hormonally get up to the age of retirement that then the replication begins and your immune system fails. They want to soft kill you at around 60, a little before retirement. But, you know, it kind of, your kid, but there's greedy interest getting in there with so many shots for your five-year-old. A lot of times they succumb to the black op. But, hey, the preacher will be at the meeting and talk about how your child's in a better place when you lower him into the ground. Because everybody knows it couldn't be as bad as Alex says. So just keep rolling your sleeves up. I mean, I don't know what I can say, sir. I mean, the guys just typed in Rockefeller Foundation, sterilants and vaccines. Their own report came up. What do you say to that?
Yeah, I know. The thing is, it's not a problem for me.
Sir, they can't find it because they don't want to. You understand that?
You know, really, what's going on right now is really, if you really want to look at it, you know, we've swallowed, we've strained out gnats and swallowed camels. I mean,
I just want to get us out of this. I know those of you that love liberty have the same desire in your heart. Every time I see old people, every time I see little children, every time I see the innocence of little boys and girls. I was just looking at Infowars.com during the break, and they had an image of Chinese children trying to avoid the flu, wearing a little mask, their little eyes full of hopes and dreams, and all being dashed and taken away. Children set in front of the television to be destroyed. Our biggest enemy is the television. I'm around it all the time, even semi-awake people. They don't have an immediacy. They're not, it's not even an intelligence issue. It's an awareness issue. People who watch a lot of television, it changes your brainwave patterns. Just type in television changes brainwave patterns. You'll get hundreds of studies. Type in television viewing Alzheimer's, television viewing IQ drop. It's a fact. Half of the UT psychology department, of the research section, which is most of it, the whole college is just a front for DARPA operations, was just how to flicker to mesmerize people. And then they had whole sections on how to subliminally arouse men and women so that you could then implant messages. It's a giant mind control factory. One visit 12 years ago to the UT psychology department. Yeah, there's a big paper. Television viewing IQ and academic achievement. That's a big paper. Let me see the top of that. Who did that paper? You can also just type in, that's the Journal of Broadcasting, that's an article in 1980. Type in television and Alzheimer's. Television and Alzheimer's. My wife's at the gun store calling, and this cannot wait. I've got to call her now on air. Hold on one moment. Firearms even take precedence over the radio show. She was calling during the break, and then every time I got on the phone, she wasn't answering. Oh, there it is. TV's linked to Alzheimer's, BBC. And it's a fact. People are mesmerized and they're chemically poisoned. Hey, honey. Yeah, you were asking me about calibers and stuff. Well, you got another 410 judge, right? What else did you get? What else did you get? They sold you a Derringer? I don't like those, honey. Whatever, we can always have, it doesn't matter. Any gun's a good gun. But the point is they, is it a 357 Derringer? I told you to get, if you want a pink one, I told you find out who's got like a 357 long-barreled classic Smith & Wesson or Colt revolver. Because, you know, you've gotten pretty good with the revolvers, so you could shoot somebody if they came over the fence in the yard, you know, at 50 yards with that right in the chest. I mean, that's a good, I mean, well, what else did you get? What is that? What is the Colt you got? 357? Well, tell me what it is. Okay. All right. Well, you wanted some more guns. That's great. I'm sorry I couldn't go with you. But I've been so the salesman sold you a regular handgun and not a revolver. Okay. Oh, you liked it. Well, whatever you want. All right. Did you get a lot of ammo for each gun? Did you get target ammo as well as hollow points? How many rounds you get? You get like 20 boxes at least? All right, I love you, honey. I'll see you later. Bye. Oh, boy. Okay, there you go. I thought she was at the gun show. I was getting all these texts about, or not the gun show, the gun shop. She wants some pink guns. None of my guns are pink. I said, okay, just go get yourself some guns. Go get yourself some pink guns if you want pink guns. Ha, And then she likes the 410 Judge I've got. That's a good little gun. So she's got one of those now. She got herself one. We have matching judges. Excuse me, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, yeah. I like that. You can listen to that all day. You'll watch me a spaghetti western now. Oh, man. Okay, let's just go back to your phone calls. Ladies and gentlemen, they're killing us. They admit they're putting it in the shots. And you know how good a news it is that they've had a 15% unenrollment or refusal to enroll for the next semester? See, they started saying in January, it's the law. You've got to take shots in Texas to be in college. They're doing it in most other states. There is no law. It's all a hoax. 15% drop. So far in the summer enrollment, others are dropping out. That's 500 classes they're going to have to cancel at the community college. They got like 9 or 10 big campuses here in Austin, taxpayer paid for, by the way. They're going to have to close 500. And they say if the trend continues at this rate, it'll be 1,000 classes or over 30% of their classes by the fall. Good. Good. See, the system doesn't care. They don't care if 42 billion, the last numbers we got, lost in 2010. That's why the travel associations, the hotel associations, the theme park associations said, please stop the groping of the genitals. Please stop the naked body scanners. It's killing the country. The TSA's answer is, yeah, bus travel's up by double. We'll just set up highway checkpoints there. You will not escape us. We will dominate you. We will be the boss. You ever been to a third world country where you pull up to checkpoints driving down the road? It's so humiliating. And the cops are on power trips and love scaring people type of folks. I mean, this is America. We're giving up our birthright because it's so fun to get scared of Al-Qaeda that publicly works for the globalist. And I was sitting there talking to some guys the other night. And they go, no, we know the government killed Pat Tillman. Yeah, we know the government's growing opium. Yeah, we know they're funding Al-Qaeda. And one guy's just like, I just can't handle it, though. I got a family.